Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Madden 23 and Madden NFL 23 Face of the Franchise. So, yeah, man. We are about to play another team and just do what. Oh, shit. Yes. And just do what we get. Just do what we do. Okay, wait. Okay, so this was probably a short week. Okay, we're gonna be playing the Bears. Alright. What should our weekly be this week? Having trouble with this so far. Yeah, we can do this one. And we might pass the 4,000 mark. All right, let's do it. Man, I still can't get over that pass, like from Williams. That pass was nice. And honestly, I didn't think I was gonna get that. I didn't think he was gonna catch it, honestly. Even though I run the same plays, I'm trying to figure out like new, different plays I can do that are gonna be complete.
Today, from Ford Field in Detroit, and Detroit getting set to go now.
Where's that? No, play action, no. There it is.
Lopez throwing on first down, dancing to his left. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that is caught at the 10-yard line. A big play there for Detroit. 61 yards. Always a benefit to have a quarterback that can roam outside of the pocket, make that throw, and I guess it's helpful to have a guy that can come down with a ball like that.
All that ties in together perfectly. Imagine being on the other side of the ball, though. You think you've got coverage. The play gets extended. Now you've got to find a receiver to plaster onto before the ball gets there. Very difficult to do.
Yeah, see, that's what I was talking about. That was a good play right there. Okay, so.
Here we go now on first and goal.
Got to get a rushing touchdown.
Here's Swift. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal.
Come on, Swift.
One more time with Swift. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Operating from the gun, Lopez. Open man, and he's got Williams. Touchdown, Lions. A great play there. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Lions get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Yes, sir.
Out is their quarterback with this offense to take over once more. He had the touchdown pass on their previous drive, and they'll search for another score as they begin here with a first and 10. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Well, Charles, this Thanksgiving tradition, so great. I mean, going back essentially through the full century of the NFL, I know you probably have a lot of fond memories of Thanksgiving Day football yourself.
I certainly do, and I don't have the Turkey Bowl tradition, you know, the families that go out and play and then come in and sit down to their feast and watch football. But I remember reading about, remember the Lions jumping on the Packers on Thanksgiving Day, the only loss the Packers had in 1962, and they sacked Mark Starr over 10 times in that game. And I remember Dave Williams from the Bears returning the overtime kickoff for a touchdown to win a game on Thanksgiving Day. I remember so many different things happening. But how much fun is it each and every year to know that you've got football on Thanksgiving Day?
Oh,
Williams. It's intercepted.
All right.
Picked off by Jalen Johnson. And the Bears are going to get the football to ears.
He looked open.
To the 38-yard line.
I mean, honestly, he looked open.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. They're riding a two-game winning streak into this Thursday nighter. How easy is it when you're on a roll to stay on a roll given the quick turnaround?
Well, you would think it'd be pretty easy because everyone's locked in practice and meetings because everyone feels good about themselves. And for coaches, this is where they have to...
Intercepted. All right.
Picked off by Jamel Dean. And the Bears are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. Their quarterback leading this offense back out, and he got off to the hot start with it.
No, someone out.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. On second down,
what the fuck was that?
He's going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now third and three. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
Sorry, what the?
On third and really? Short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Forced out to his left. Oh, he's hit. He lost the football.
Come on.
And now, meanwhile, after the dust settles on the fumble, we've got an injured player here as well.
Good.
So as the medical staff takes Jesus, a look, we'll step aside.
That is frustrating.
So here come the Lions now. On first down. Lopez buying time to his left. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Detroit. Jameson Williams, his second TD of the game and 16th on the season. And the Lions have moved out in front. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that. And one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
Let's keep it moving, man.
He threw touchdown pass number 30 on the year last time he had the ball. To throw is Lopez. Throwing to start the drive. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. You know, thinking of this Thanksgiving Day game, Charles, for years we've heard the talk, why don't we open up these Thanksgiving Day games instead of just being Detroit and Dallas every year, give other teams a shot to host? I know you're kind of like me, a bit of a traditionalist, but what do you have to say to that, CD?
I think it's a great argument, and the league could support.
And that's caught inside the 30. And they're going to move it down inside the 25.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. pretty good.
Open man, and he's got Williams. Touchdown Lions.
Even though I took a hit.
A great effort there. On his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Lions will extend their lead here just before halftime.
And that lead is now 7 with a chance to go to 8 or more if they want to get crazy here, which we don't expect. But I just know the way the game's being played with the analytics, there's going to be a lot more of going for 2 in a lot of situations, isn't there?
Yeah, there's going to be. And now I think they're focused. So here are the Lions to take over. They've won 2 straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on 1st and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Lopez. He's airing it out for Williams. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown. Jameson Williams. 75 yards. And the Lions come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the 3rd quarter. And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation. Knowing when it exists to go to it, they did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like...
I didn't even think that I was going to get that, honestly.
Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. Lopez now on 1st and 10.
Oh, we got
the field, but it's incomplete.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. Now a good job shifting right, finding his target. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 22 yards there, a 1st down. Inside 4 minutes to go, 3rd quarter. Here's Lopez on 1st down. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
He's got a man complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 33 yards that time.
When they needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
All right, let's go.
They go play action here on 1st down. Out to his left. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a 1st down. Swift going to try up the middle. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just the 3rd quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances, so they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
Swift again, but he went backwards as he stopped for a loss. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Oh! 3rd down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. And Detroit back in possession of the football. Now Lopez throwing to start the drive. He's airing it out for Williams.
Oh,
it's incomplete. Good positioning there downfield.
Try that one more time. That one up.
So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. Looking to throw. Lopez. But he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
All right.
And quickly they get to the line. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. This one caught. It's the tight end, Hockenson. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Third and 19, no problem as they're able to convert. His tremendous season passing the football, it continues, Charles. That last throw puts him over 4,000 yards now on the year.
And he's still got the rest of November and all of December still to play. So to me, 5,000 yards, very much in play.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's airing it out for Williams. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. A big play there for Detroit.
Wait, I got 4,000 yards? Okay, I didn't even know that. Get in there.
He's gonna go backwards. He'll lose yardage.
Okay, I'm done going to you.
Back at the 5-yard line now. Second and goal. Off play action. Lopez. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
As expected, he's gone to him several times in this game, but that's the first time one has slipped from his grasp. I bet he goes back to him, though. He's an excellent player.
I'm done going this way.
Lopez, gonna throw on third and goal. Open man, and he's got Williams. Touchdown, Lions. A 5-yard touchdown catch, and the Lions are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. And you wonder now if he might be able to remove the helmet, put on the baseball cap, and watch the rest of this one from the sideline. His fifth touchdown pass of the game.
Say that again. Did you say fifth touchdown pass of the game?
Yes, sir.
Boy, that's a heck of a performance, isn't it? Because they've had no answer for him at all game long. Receivers have been...
So out now come the Lions. To throw is Lopez. Throwing to start the drive. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone.
Oh, dang it. Shouldn't have.
Incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Jameson Williams. With touchdown number 20 on the year, and the Lions are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. He's got them out now to a 3-score lead here in the fourth quarter after that one, CD. And well, he looked right off the line like he knew that ball was coming his way, and he secured it for 6 points.
Yeah, I think when you're leading by a healthy margin already, it actually loosens you up and allows you to take maybe a few more chances and definitely play with more confidence, because he certainly saw something he could exploit in the defense, and he made sure to let his quarterback know, just get it to me. And the rest was all up to him, and he delivered and made it a 3-score game.
All right.
Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. They've got to be feeling very comfortable and confident here with this lead in the football. Throwing to start the drive. Lopez flush to his right. That pass caught. It's Williams. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Lopez now. Throwing on first down.
Oh!
And his throw is incomplete. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Williams brings it in. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line. The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third down. They'll look to throw again. Escaping the pressure right. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
It hasn't been the cleanest game for him, but there was a sign of improvement as he looks towards the next one. Nice bit of scrambling to move the sticks, and even more importantly, he didn't risk adding another interception to his ledger.
The quick slant caught, and in for the Lions touchdown. Amon-Ra St. Brown, a 14-yard touchdown, as his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead.
But not much defensive resistance on that drive. And really, Charles, the way this offense has been humming, they haven't faced much defensive resistance the entire game.
Yeah, I think it's safe to say that one team, their defense did not wake up and make it to the stadium for this one. There may be some major changes on that side of the ball when we see them the next time out.
The Lions offense set to take over.
Alrighty. Wait.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts.
That'll I know I don't have to, but I want to try to see if I can get it. I just want to see if I can get it.
Here's Lopez. Throwing to start the drive. He's airing it out for Williams.
Okay, well, it's fine. It's fine.
Time. Picked off by Jamel Dean.
It's fine.
Well, this was a fun one today if you like points. A lot of them went on the board. Both offenses were clicking. Charles's defenses, meanwhile, have a little something to clean up before their next contest.
Yeah, neither end zone had a stop sign in it, did they? I mean, for both sides, visit it, and with frequency. Not fun to be a defensive player, but on the offensive side of the ball, those guys had a blast. One team came away with a victory, even better for them.
So for Detroit, their playoff chances take an uptick as they move to 7-4. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week where they take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Meanwhile, for Chicago, it's starting to look like it won't be their year as they drop to 5-6. And they'll try again next week at home against Philadelphia. So that'll do it.
500-yard passing,
Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports.
All right, so next we need to get to
5,000.
So next we need to get to 5,000 yards. Okay. Because they just said we just reached 4,000 yards. All right, let's advance to next week. Okay, guys, well, that's it for the video. Like and subscribe if you like the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy.